Our family originated in England, came over to Maine, and then eventually settled in Illinois, then moved on to Furnessville and created the village of Furnessville.
Furnessville was started by two Furness brothers, William Furness and E.L. Furness. And they brought their grandmother and with them from Maine. And her name is Martha Chadbourne Furness, and she's buried in the cemetery. You know the obelisk in the cemetery is Furness?
Yeah.
That was built by E.L.'s daughter. William's wife, and they were in Maine, they got married in Maine, and her name was Keturah Ann Watts. And her father was a sea captain, but also her family came over on the Mayflower.
Tell us about when it became named.
And then Furnessville, because E.L. became the postmaster. He was the first postmaster, and because he was the first postmaster, he got to name it.
We come from pioneer stock and are a very hardy, sturdy family.
Growing up on the farm in Furnessville, used to have workhorses. Used to plant corn and cut alfalfa hay with the horses. Sisters had riding horses. You have to help milk the cows, clean the barn out, horse manure, cow manure. A lot of hard work.
I'm Pat, I'm the last of 10. The one that they could blame for all their troubles. I used to go to Pine School and we play volleyball. And I'd walk home from volleyball at night, like 10 o'clock at night. And my brother comes by and he starts yelling at me for walking down the road at night. And I'm thinking, wow, my big brother cares about the baby. I was so impressed with that.
Which big brother was that?
Lester.
And so it's your big brother.
Right, the oldest one.
Yeah, that was nice.
So I remember that. He cared about his baby sister.
This shirt is representing Audrey, who was number 8 in a family of 10. She was kind of a wanderer. She'd like to go places and do things and was very independent.
Who's the funniest sibling in your family?
That's a pretty good question now. If you ask who was the meanest, I might be able to answer you.
Okay, tell us that one.
It might be the one you're looking at.
My Herschel story is that Herschel would come over to my grandmother's house when I was there, and he had a favorite, two favorite sayings that I remember the most, and actually I taught them to my children. One was, the only thing better than beans is mo beans, because I thought you'd remember that one too. And then you can call me anything, but
don't call me late for dinner.
Bingo. Those are my two.
And I can remember when I was a tiny little girl, we used to go see Grandpa Herschel, and he would ask me to come and sit on his lap and count his fingers. And I was like 4 years old, and I could count to 10, and I would only count to 9. And he would say, no, I did it wrong, there's 10. And so I kept trying to find the 10th finger, but he had lost it in an accident. So he just kept kidding us. It was his favorite joke with the little children.
I always enjoy coming here out to the farm because I was a city girl. I don't know, they just had a very warm feeling when you went to there. And my Aunt Lady was a great cook.
I'm from Furnessville. I have strong feelings towards it. And I just feel it's my home.
The Furnessville Cemetery has a lot of Furness members, and it would be nice if our great-grandchildren would keep it maintained and beautified.
One of my fondest memories of Furnessville is the people.
Well, I was born in a small town, and I lived in a small town. Enough to say, look who's in the big town. But my bed is in a small town. Oh, that's good enough for me. Well, I was born in a small town, and I can breathe in a small town.